Hello and welcome to the Archie Luxury Channel. Today I'd like to talk about my wife's watches. And the reason I'm put this video together is because I recently put a video together yesterday. Actually, yesterday I put the video together, and it was from Kelly and Lance in Canada, and they were asking about ladies' watches, and they very kindly sent me some photos of their ladies' collection, and I thought, well, look, I better put a collection about some of the pieces that I've bought for my wife, and you can just see some of the lovely pieces there. Look, I haven't put a lot of videos together on ladies' watches, and that's basically because my punters, my customers, my viewers are mainly interested in men's watches. But look, I got to tell you the truth there. You know, if you want to keep the lady in your life satisfied, and it's a serious relationship, you really got to get her some beautiful pieces. That way there, they won't bitch about that Patek you just bought, or that Submariner, or the Explorer. They won't whinge, you know, and this is very important. And the other thing too is, if you buy them some lovely pieces, you'll certainly get, you know, this is in my opinion, you'll get better service in the bedroom. So, you know, that I think it's an investment, and that's my view. So let's have a look at some of the choices that Archie has made there. Okay, the first watch is the Holy Grail, the Fuck Off watch. And my wife did actually have a Rolex President, a 69178. And it was with a factory diamond dial, and we put an aftermarket bezel on. But, you know, that's very 90s, and times are a-changing. And I said to her, hey, let's sell that, and let's get a Patek. And we basically, I said, what Patek would you want? She wanted a 24. And she wanted a 24 with a dark dial, either a dark blue or a black dial. So we then picked up this beautiful Patek 24 from a dealer that I've known for many, many years. And I got to say, yeah, it's a lovely piece. It's a Patek 24. She chose it. I didn't choose it. You know, I mean, this is the thing. The Patek 24 is a very much a premium piece. You pay a lot of money for it. For similar money, I could have possibly got a solid gold Patek in a different model. A ladies Patek we're talking. But that's not the point. The point is, she loves the Patek 24, and mission accomplished. So that's the Holy Grail Fuck Off piece. The next piece is my wife's steel Datejust, Rolex Datejust, with white gold bezel. And I'm a firm believer that every collection needs a Rolex, because a Rolex is waterproof. You can wear it every day. It's just a fantastic, you know, it's a watch that you can wear when you're doing shit. That's my own opinion there. So I think a Rolex is waterproof. It's just so it's every collection needs a good sturdy tight watch there. And I think with a Rolex you can't really get better than that. It's got Stardust. So this is actually my wife's, it's a 69174, and my wife's had a string of Datejusts. She's had a lot of two-tone ones, 6917, 69173s, various models there. And I have done a bit of wheeler dealing, but you know, my wheeler dealing days are sort of I'm getting sick of trading and selling things, so I don't think we'll be getting out of these ones here. This is our collection now. The reason I say that is the country that I live in, Australia. The Aussie dollar's so high. The supply chain in Asia is difficult because of the Chinese buying a lot of pieces. So I really, it's just too fucking hard to make a quid out of it. But my wife's steel Datejust with white gold bezel, I think it's just a great piece here. This is a early to mid 90s piece. It's a great, honest, just everyday watch that you can wear. And I've got to say, to be honest with you, the steel ones now with the white gold bezel are slightly in Singapore and places like that, they're slightly more expensive or same price as a two-tone one. So there's no premium for the two-tone, which makes the two-tone really good value pieces. But I think this is quite a nice piece. The next piece is my wife's Cartier Diablo. Now, this is a great piece. This is one that I bought for her many, many years ago. And it's one of these pieces that I just absolutely fell in love with when I saw it. And this is not the first watch I bought for my wife, but it's one of these watches that's a keeper. Because I very easily say to her, look, let's get rid of that. I'll give you this. Just trade up. But this Cartier Diablo, 18 karat solid gold. It's got the 18 karat Cartier buckle, and I think it's just gorgeous with the five sapphires. It's just beautiful. My wife's a petite Japanese lady, so it's the mini size. It's just absolutely perfect, and I just think it's a gorgeous piece. And this is the piece she's had the longest that I've given her. The next piece is a Cartier Diablo. This is an 18 karat piece. It's a mini version again. And this piece here I bought for my wife's 40th birthday, and I just love it. I think it's a Banois, Cartier Banois. I think it's French for bathtub Banois. It's just so chic and gorgeous. And this one doesn't have the crown. It's got you adjust the time by a push button on the back, because it's the mini size. It's just elegant French chic. So there you have it. That's a wrap-up of my wife's current collection. And I hope you've enjoyed this. Give me some feedback if you want me to do more segments on ladies' watches. I'm happy to consider it. But the demographic is what it is. And I've got mainly male punters who are interested in my watch videos. And, sometimes Archie uses one too many fucks in his video, so it sort of scares the female clientele away. So yeah, that's just how it goes. I'm Archie Luxury. Thank you very much.